Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about sound fields. It's the way that sound moves around in your room, and a lot of people ask me, how'd you get the name Acoustic Fields? Well, it came out as a direct result of sound fields. Let's look at how energy is distributed within our room, and I think this will help a lot of you understand some of the questions that you've been asking me over the last couple weeks about reflections and pressure and imaging and stuff like that. So what do we have for first off? We have side to side, side walls to side walls. We have this lateral element to our sound stage and to our room. So we have energy that's going from sidewall to sidewall. What's involved in that? Well, we have image focus. You know, when you get a strong central image in your sound stage, you have good image focus. If you have the side to side lateral reflections, regulated, so to speak, and maintained. And then you have definition, separation, and we always have modal issues from sidewall to sidewall. So those are issues that we have to be concerned about. What's the next sound field that we look at? Floor to ceiling. The floor to ceiling area is the area of highest pressure almost always. Why? Because it's the shortest dimension. Our standard dimension in North America is 8 foot. Well, that's really problematic for frequencies that are trying to fit in that small space. So 60, 70, 80 cycle wavelengths, 100 cycles even in some cases. So anything from 100 cycles below is going to be problematic with floor to ceiling heights of 8, 9, anything under 11 foot. So we have to realize that. So we have that impacts the floor to ceiling element impacts the height of our sound stage. And obviously the modal structures that we talked about, the unwanted low frequency pressure areas, which can just destroy and wreak havoc with any kind of presentation you're trying to create, especially with two channels. Our third sound field, if you will, is front to back. We've got energy moving from the front of the room to the back of the room. So we have side to side, floor to ceiling, and then we have front to back. So we have these three areas that we have to look at. Spaciousness, a really big thing with front to back imaging. If you take a series of diffusers or absorbers and you move them closer to the listening chair from the rear wall, you'll immediately sense that spaciousness because you're making the room physically smaller. So you're changing all the reflections, you're changing all the time signatures on those reflections, and you're impacting the pressure distribution in those areas. So front to back, spaciousness, definition. Most of you don't have the luxury of moving your rear wall forward, but we do in our studio because we have portable units. But try it sometime and you'll get the idea. So we have three sound fields in our room that we have to be focused on. Side to side energy, floor to ceiling, and front to back. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give me a thumbs up so I know that it had value to you. And please, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. And I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. Alternatively, if there are other topics that you wish to discuss or see discussed in a video presentation, send me an email, info@acousticfields.com, and we'll get them on our list and get them done for you. I release a new video about every week, so stay tuned to our YouTube channel and keep updated on our new videos.